Hello everyone, my name is Dan. I hope you all are doing amazing today because we're going to be talking about what is inheritance and why you must use it in Unity and C#. Let's go! What is inheritance, you may ask? Well, I've actually covered it in the previous tutorial episodes of this series. I mentioned it very, very briefly, so let us cover it more in depth this time around. Inheritance is a principle of object-oriented programming, and it allows us to use fields and methods from other classes without having to rewrite them in a new class. Because oftentimes we would be having classes that would have similar things, and instead of having to rewrite them always, it's best to just write them once and reuse them later. So right over here, I'm showing you the person class example that I've been using for the past two tutorials. And already we're using the principle of inheritance by inheriting from the MonoBehaviour class over here. And we're doing this to expose this class as a component that can be attached to a game object in Unity. So if you haven't watched the first episode of this tutorial series, I talk about the MonoBehaviour class, and I recommend that you take a look at it. So I actually created two more classes called the CoolPerson class and the SuperCoolPerson class. As you can see, those three classes are all different, and if you haven't noticed yet, they have repeating fields and some repeating methods. For example, each one of them has a full name field and an age field. They all have the introduce method as well. So there's of course a lot of repetition going on here, and to fix it, we must use inheritance. So what we should do is, instead of inheriting from the MonoBehaviour class, let's inherit from the person class. And let's remove the things that we've already declared in our person class. Let's do the same thing for the super cool person class. And instead of inheriting from the person class, we can also inherit from the cool person class, because those two classes share this field and this method right here together. By using inheritance, we were able to decrease the amount of code. If we go to Unity right now, I actually have this example scene that I have prepared. As you can see, I have three different game objects: the person, cool person, and super cool person game objects. And those have their respective scripts. And if you haven't noticed already, the cool person class has the full name and age fields, regardless of us actually declaring them in the cool person class. And the reason why this is happening is because we're actually inheriting the cool person class from the person class, which allows us to use these fields in the cool person class. Now, in this case right here, we actually can't use them because those two fields are marked as private. If we were to recall our previous episode, to access a field or a method or whatever in the child class, we must mark the code as protected. And in this case, we'll actually be able to use those fields just like this. And if we were to set them back to private, we would get an error for our full name field because it is private and it must be protected or public for us to access it in our derived class. The same thing applies to the super cool person class because it inherits from the cool person class. There's actually one more interesting thing about inheritance in Unity, and to explain it, I have another class right here called person manager, which inherits from MonoBehaviour. I attached it to this person manager game object. It has a person field right here, which takes in a type of person. I can actually attach to this person object field the cool person object as well. Even though it doesn't have a person component And the reason why this is happening is, as you've probably guessed already, it's because the cool person class is inheriting from the person class. The same can be done with the super cool person class. We can attach it either way because the person class is the parent of the cool person class. So this person manager script will call the introduce method on a person class. Let's actually try and test it with our super cool person attached to the person field. And there you go, it works just fine. As you can see, the field's values all match up. So what if we wanted our class not to be inheritable? Well, we can certainly do that by using a keyword called sealed. And we have to put it right at the front of our class keyword over here. Let's actually try and do this on the cool person class, because in that way we'll be able to get an error right over here, which says that we cannot inherit from the sealed class cool person because it's marked with sealed. Let's remove it because we want to inherit from the cool person class in this case. Going back to our person manager class, what if we wanted to check if our person field right here, even though it is a type of person class, check if it's actually a type of cool person? Well, we can certainly do that, and there are actually two ways of doing it. This will work. However, if our person field will not have a value of an object that is the type of a cool person class or the super cool person class, then we will get an error which will say specified cast is not valid. So what we're doing here is we're actually casting the cool person type to the person field, which turns it into a cool person. So a more safer way of doing it is by using the as keyword. So if we go ahead and run this now, we will still get an error. However, this time it's a different one, and we're actually not getting it from the same place as we did, because we're actually not getting an error from the casting. We're getting an error from this line over here, because if our person does not end up being a type of cool person or super cool person, because it derives from cool person, then we will actually get an object that is null. And because we're trying to call the say something cool method from a null object, it will cause a null reference exception error. So how do we prevent that? Well, we can actually use another keyword in this case, which is called the is keyword. If we now go ahead and run this again, as you can see, we didn't get any error. And that is because we actually do an if check if our person is the type of cool person. If we were to attach the cool person, on the other hand, then we will get the I'm cool line as well, because that's what happens when we run the say something cool method. Moreover, we can simplify this by using a pattern variable like this. So when dealing with types or casting two types, the operator keywords such as and is are what we need to use. I will leave more information on the is and as operator keywords in the description down below. Now let us go ahead and move to a more practical example of inheritance. Made this scene where I can move around, I can jump, and I can shoot this slime enemy right here, which can also jump and damage me, and I can destroy it if I get its HP down, just like so. Now, what if I wanted here to have two types of slimes, not just one? One that will be just normal, and the other one that will be big, and once it dies, it will spawn two more little slimes. To do so, I can just create two scripts, which I have already done. One for the slime and one for this super slime, which I'm going to drag into the scene right here. And as you can see, it has a super slime script attached to it. Let's review both of those scripts in our code editor, shall we? So here is the slime class. It has all of the logic for its movement and for its taking damage. And now if we move on to the super slime script, we can see that it does the exact same thing. So instead of rewriting everything right over here, let us actually just remove everything in here. Yes, let's just remove it. Let's add the things that we actually need. Oh yeah, and before that, let's actually derive from the slime class. And now let's write the things that we need to do, which is spawning two slimes when the slime gets destroyed. So how do we do that? Well, I'm gonna use the onDestroyEvent function. And inside, I'm basically gonna instantiate two slime prefabs. So first we have to create a slime prefab field. And now let's actually do the spawning part. So just like so, we are getting the position and we are spawning two slimes just at the right side and the left side of the slime that is about to die. So now if we take a look at our super slime script, it has all the fields that are inside of the slime class, but it also has this slime prefab field to which we're gonna assign our slime prefab right over here. All the previous fields appear because it's deriving from the slime class. So let me kill this little slime first, and now let's destroy this big slime as well. And as you can see, it spawns in two little slimes which are about to destroy me. But as you can see, what we've written works just fine. So if I were to show you this bullet class, which I have, which is a script that gets attached to every single bullet that gets instantiated by the player, it actually has this onCollisionEnter2D event function, which checks if the component that is attached to the object that we're colliding with has the slime component. With this logic in here, both the slime and the super slime will get damaged because the super slime class derives from the slime class. So to conclude, inheritance can be very handy and useful when we are dealing with creating many types of enemies, weapons, items, whatever has many kinds of variants. Inheritance can be really useful for it. And so inheritance is very important for the reusability of our code. So that's it for this video, guys. I hope you were able to learn something new about inheritance in Unity and C#. Let me know down in the comments below if you have any questions or if you have any suggestions for my videos. Please leave a like if you enjoyed the video, and make sure to subscribe if you're excited for more of these tutorials. And I will see you guys next time. Peace out.